Our next speaker is Dr. Sonja Südbeck. Dr. Sonja Südbeck, she studied at the Julius Maximilians University in Würzburg in Germany, and she's actually currently doing her PhD at the LMU University in Munich in the department from Professor Daniel Edelhoff. And in the context of her PhD, she actually executed the study that we performed with the Munich University to research the stability of the matrix system. And Sonja, she's definitely the person who has produced most matrix crowns, and she has milled hundreds of matrix crowns from different materials and compared them to crowns on a tie basis. So I'm very happy to introduce to the stage Dr. Sonja Südbeck with her TRI talk with the topic researching the mechanical stability of matrix. So Sonja, thank you for coming, and I'm looking forward to your TRI talk.
Thank you for that very kind introduction. I'm really happy I can be here today and share my experiences with you. As we have heard this morning earlier, previous researchers often reported on better stability for titanium to titanium implant abutment connections when compared to titanium to zirconia implant abutment connections, and therefore didn't quite see zirconia abutments as state of art in dental implantology. However, with the revolutionary and zirconia-specific implant... Oh, let's see. Yeah. with the new implant abutment interface design and the many advantages given, we were curious, so we investigated the new implant system in an in vitro study and examined the influence of restoration material and artificial aging on the bending moments of single unit FDPs. As for the study design, we compared the matrix implants with the traditional octa implants with titanium bases. We used five different materials. So for group one, it was zirconia of the first generation, which contains 3% of yttria and shows really high strength values. For group two, it was zirconia of the third generation. Group three and four, we used zirconia of the fourth generation. And for the last group, cobalt chrome molybdenum alloy was used. Like group 1, 2, and 5, group 3 was conventionally sintered, while for group 4, we used a high-speed sintering program. From these materials, we fabricated 48 crowns each, so 24 per implant type. We artificially aged half of the specimens before testing all of them on the bending moment. To do so, we milled the crowns from the blanks. We sintered them, like I said before, either conventionally or with a high-speed sintering program. Afterwards, we polished them as recommended by the manufacturer. And then for the octa implants, we air abraded the crowns and conditioned them before luting them to the titanium bases. Then we screwed the crown titanium base complex to the implant, whereas for the matrix implant, the crowns could directly be screwed on the implants. The crowns were then stored in water for 24 hours at 37 degrees Celsius to assure the complete polymerization of the luting material. And afterwards, half of the specimens were artificially aged by loading them for 1.2 million cycles with 50 newtons and a lateral movement of 0.7 millimeters. This imitates about an in vivo period of 5 years. I also brought a video to you, so you can see how the chewing simulator worked. I guess it's nice to see how the crowns were actually chewed for 1.2 million times. Yes, and afterwards, all the specimens were tested on the fracture load, and the bending moment was calculated. The results then showed that when initially tested, so the upper part, the matrix implants actually showed significantly higher values in bending moment than the octa implants when combined with zirconia crowns. Only the group with cobalt chrome, in that group, it was the other way around, and octa implants showed higher values. For the materials, it can be said that the high-speed sintered zirconia of the fourth generation exhibited the highest values for both types of implants. And the lowest values were observed for cobalt chrome with the matrix implants, or zirconia of the first and the third generation with the octa implants. Artificial aging also had an impact on all groups except three. It reduced the values of the bending moments and also increased the spread. The one specimen at the bottom you can see, it was one specimen that failed during chewing simulation, so it was rated with zero, but I will come to that later on and show some pictures too. After aging, there were no differences observed between both the materials and the implant types. We also analyzed the fracture types, and it was clear to see that implant deformation mainly occurred for matrix implants, while mobility of the crown was mainly observed with the octa implants. With the traditional octa implants, yes. We also have one picture of the deformed implants. And furthermore, we noticed some crown fractures, but it was only or mainly observed with zirconia of the third generation. This also is one picture. The left picture is a matrix implant, and the right one is an octa implant. After aging, it was similar. There was also implant deformation mainly observed with matrix implants, and mobility of the crowns was mainly observed with octa implants. Except for cobalt chrome molybdenum, there was the other way around. And in this group, there was also that one specimen that failed during chewing simulation due to screw fracture. Complete crown fracture was also mainly observed amongst the crowns of zirconia of the third generation, like the initially tested groups. And for better visualization, we also fabricated cross sections. And here it's really nice to see. In the upper part is the octa implants, and the lower parts are the matrix implants. And I hope you can see that from the back too, but the octa implants showed fractures within the implant, while the matrix specimens showed fractures within the crowns. The left pictures are the crowns that fractured completely, and the last picture shows that fractured or failed specimen that from group cobalt chromium. So from all these results, one has to keep in mind that we used really, really high forces, about 1,500 to 3,000 Newton, which exceed the average human biting force by far. So it can be concluded that the mechanical stability of directly screwed FDPs is sufficient for clinical use, especially with the tested materials, and that it is a promising alternative treatment method, I can say. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sonja, for your hard work in the last 6 months and this nice presentation. I think I have one question, but you already talked about it, but still, this is a question we receive sometimes. Did you observe any screw loosening for the matrix or tie-base implants?
We did observe one screw fracture, like I showed before, for matrix implants. And we did observe quite a few screw loosenings for octa implants, but barely any. I think it was one or two for the matrix implants. It was very, very high stability.
I mean, in Munich, you have a lot of experience with zirconia on titanium. Mm-hmm. You have performed a lot of studies, and most studies show actually that zirconia on titanium is significantly weaker than titanium on titanium. Very surprised to see these results, you know, that suddenly a zirconia on titanium is the same or in the beginning even better. Yeah.
Yes, it was very nice to see.
Yeah, cool, great. Yeah. Thank you very much, Sonja. This
Thank
is
you.
Our present for us.
Thanks so much.
For coming here.
Thank you.
Thanks again, Sonja, for your TRI talk.